In my background, I was a designer by trade. I literally had no medical background whatsoever. So I really learned through the school of hard knocks, if you will, how to navigate through this very tangled web of clinical trials. My youngest sister's husband, Mike, was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer in his early 40s. And that is a very dire diagnosis. And so he went on to receive chemotherapy, and they asked me if I would please look into cancer clinical trials for him. It was really a difficult undertaking. It took me 5 weeks to identify some potential trials for him. And then once we got him enrolled in a trial, we began to understand the barriers around clinical trial participation, particularly around out-of-pocket expense for travel. And while Mike was going through his treatment process, he met lots of other patients. He was doing well, and they asked him, hey, what are you doing? And he said, oh, just call my sister-in-law, Dana, she'll help you. And literally, that's how Lazarex began. We lost Mike, but the phone kept ringing, and here we are, 15 years and 7,000 patients later. The mission of Lazarex Cancer Foundation is to improve enrollment and diversity in cancer clinical trials, and also to address cancer health disparities and improve cancer health outcomes. We fulfill this mission by working with patients one-on-one through their diagnosis, their treatment history, their personal situation at home, their ability to travel. We help them navigate through their clinical trial opportunities, and then if they decide to participate in a trial, we actually provide assistance with the travel costs for not just them, but also a travel companion, because in many instances, cancer patients just can't physically travel alone, and also they don't want to be alone. At that point in your disease, if you're on a clinical trial, you may have limited time, and you know, patients want to be with their friends and their family at that time.
What struck me about Dana and the Lazarex Cancer Foundation included the quality of the work that they were doing to remove financial barriers for patients participating in clinical trials. So the way that they were making interventions for patients, supporting their needs in clinical trials, ensuring that patients could participate in clinical trials and benefit from that care environment, stood out as something that I hadn't heard from other patient advocacy organizations. And the passion behind which Dana actually led that work. Every time we had an opportunity to interact with Dana, everybody left out of that meeting with a sense of inspiration. She was able to exchange her passion for being able to support patients in this way. And I think it was that impression that has really enabled us to collaborate well together and drive more impact for patients.
Trial participation is really the key element to completing the clinical trial process. If we don't have adequate participation, and especially if we don't have adequate diversity of clinical trial participants, then we're not developing drugs, we're not able to get, you know, drugs to market, but also we're not developing drugs for everyone. A lot of our work now is focused with community outreach and engagement, and actually being in the communities of color where, you know, they may have a higher risk of developing cancer and cancer mortality. And so we've started a program called the Cancer Wellness Hub, which is place-based, community-led, and culturally appropriate and linguistically appropriate.
What makes Dana unique is her passion to drive change and to support all patients of all backgrounds. She stands up. She's, you know, very energized. You can see the passion for change in this specific space. It's evident, and you can feel it. And that makes people lean forward in their seats and pay attention.
Our patients are our greatest source of joy. They keep us going every day. Just when you kind of lose sight of what it is that you're doing for patients, we'll get a phone call, or we'll get a card in the mail, you know, that says, hey, just want you to know, I no longer need your services because I'm in remission, or I'm off my trial and I've had a successful response. Those are the things that, you know, really give us hope and keep us going. They're always grateful for our help and support, and we are always grateful for their response.